Salutations, Celestial Sightseers. I'm David Fuller. Welcome to Eyes in the Sky. What's up this week? If we're looking over in the northwestern part of the sky, we can see this fantastic open cluster. However, it's kind of in a really dim part of the sky. Because when we back up a little bit, we can see there's not too many stars there, but there's a neat little trailing of stars that leads over to our open cluster. Unfortunately, most of the rest of the stars in this area are fourth or fifth magnitude and dimmer, which means we have to work at it a little bit to find this area. So how do we do that? Let's back out, and I will show you exactly how to do that. We're going to turn on our constellation lines and even the constellation labels, and we can see that we've got Cassiopeia and Perseus nearby, and the open cluster that we're going towards is NGC 1502, which is in the constellation of Camelopardalis. And that particular constellation, the giraffe, is really dim. Its brightest stars are just fourth magnitude, and then they get dimmer from there. So you're either going to need dark skies or some binoculars to be able to find where we're going. But if you can't even really see the stars up there, how do you even know where to point? Because that's a good distance away. That's about 15 degrees away from Epsilon Cassiopeia here, or Alpha Persei over here in Perseus. So the way to find this particular cluster is you need to kind of triangulate. And we're going to draw one line from one direction, another line from the other direction, and we'll be able to see where we're going. If we go across the top of Cassiopeia, so we're literally going to go from here, which is Beta Cassiopeiae, across the very tops of the tips of that W shape over to Epsilon Cassiopeiae, and we will take our pointer and kind of go this direction like this. And we're going to go about 27 or so degrees right next to where this line is, would be coming through for Camelopardalis. And what I will do is I'm going to zoom in on that area. And actually, you can see there's our cluster and there's our little trailing of stars, which I'll talk about in a moment. So we know we're in the right spot if we go that along that line. Now, the other line that we need to follow is from Beta Persei, which is Algol down here in Perseus, through Alpha Persei, the brightest star in Perseus, up here. We're going to follow those on a line out like this. Again, kind of go to that same spot. I'm going to zoom in again, and you can see we're also, again, in the right spot. So those two lines are going to intersect right where this little trail of stars is. So we can use binoculars to kind of find our way into that area. I'll turn off all these little cheating systems, and we'll just go ahead and put some binoculars on this area. And that is a binocular view of this particular region of the sky. You can see this little trailing of stars, maybe if you're using HD and can see it. They look pretty faint. They're going to look faint if you're using binoculars too. But the important thing is that you can see this fifth magnitude star. You can see these fifth magnitude stars, and you can see these fifth magnitude stars. So there's sort of this squashed T shape that's in there. It's sort of got the bent line coming this way, and then a very long line across the top there. So that's not difficult to find with binoculars. So if you can locate that, you're in good shape. You're going to look for the center of the top of the T there, and that's going to be the star that's right in the middle of that little trailing of stars, and that is Kemble's Cascade. Now, what Kemble's Cascade is just this line of eighth and ninth magnitude stars that kind of cascades along this area right here. You can see how there's just this neat flowing of stars, and it was named Kemble's Cascade because Father Lucian Kemble wrote to Walter Scott Houston of Sky and Telescope magazine and said, hey, there's this really neat asterism of stars in the sky, and so Walter Scott Houston dubbed it Kemble's Cascade, and we've just kind of known it ever since as that. It's not a bunch of related stars, it just happened to be line of sight from where we are, from our solar system, and they're all about the same magnitude, just interrupted by this bright fifth magnitude star here. Now, the important thing is, though, is that it's fairly large. This is about 2.5 degrees across, so you're not going to be able to see that in all but the very widest fields of view of telescopes. If you've got a very fast focal length telescope with a really wide eyepiece, you may be able to see all of this in one field of view. Most of us won't, though. We'll probably have to start at one end and just kind of work our way across, maybe capture a third or even half of it at once, and then work our way towards the other half. And it's worth even doing that. One thing I do want to mention is if you're using binoculars, you may want to use something that is a bracket for them, because it's going to hold the binoculars in place. When you're holding the binoculars, you can actually see more stars, because instead of it, the binoculars moving while your heart is beating and jiggling slightly, with them nice and steady like this, you will be able to bring in a little bit dimmer stars. And this particular bracket, you can see, has a mirror on it, and there's that's a great way to be able to look down at things instead of having to look up. So that's one option that you might be able to do. But when you do get to the end up here, there's a treat and there's a surprise waiting, because there's actually an open cluster there, which is NGC 1502. So if we zoom in on that, you can see that with a 6-inch reflector at about 75 times or so, and about 3/4 of a degree field of view, we've got a nice tight grouping of stars, because this is not a large cluster. It's only about 8 arc minutes across, so fairly small, but a lot of the stars in it are bright enough that they're easy to see even through light pollution. And there's a double star right in the middle, so if you do use a little bit more magnification, you can see how there's these two stars right next to each other, right in the heart of the open cluster itself. It's a pretty easy one to identify, because it's going to look like a triangle shape, and it's also fairly bright at 5.7 magnitude. At that fairly small size, it stands out pretty well, even though it's got some dimmer members. If you have a larger telescope, you can definitely add a couple more stars in there. But for the most part, you're going to see a couple dozen stars. It only has about 4 dozen or so total. If you see 2 dozen, you're doing really well. But it's a great cluster to take a look at the end of Kemble's Cascade in Camelopardalis near Cassiopeia and Perseus. So that's all for this week. Keep your eyes on the sky and your outdoor lights aimed down, so we can all see what's up. I'm David Fuller, wishing you clear and dark skies.